So this one gets the 3. Yeah, I probably could have done this earlier. Alright, so these are my 3 cards. And they are 3¼. And I have 10 inches here. So I know. If I cut them at, use my white gel pen to mark this with. Alright, I put 2 of them in here. Well, there's my scissors I wanted. Alright, so what I'm going to do is mark 3⅛ and 6¼. Alright, this would be 9⅜. Whoops, no. Let's go with 3¼, 6½, 9¾. It'll work out. Because I'll be trimming. Yeah, I should have trimmed these too. Before I put them in. Learn. Yeah, I should have made all my cuts before. Cringe now. Okay. That came right off. I'm using my ruler behind my X-Acto knife. Thing is, once I get it scored enough, I can come in with my scissors and trim it. That's thick. I know it's going to be this thick. I want to put the pockets in like this. Okay. Well, we've also got that tie back in there, which is part of the problem. Just get that little bit cleaned up. May not have been my best idea. Other a couple of these knives, so I
Mama.
Close for that being done?
Yeah, I just gotta put these extra pockets in. Do the mats and that. Just having issues with this. I should have done this before. I put the stuff in the book.
Alright, I'll give you a cute piece on my bed.
You know I'm taping.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Mittens, I'm playing with sharp objects.
The cat just became part of your tape.
She doesn't care.
Hi.
Let me tell you, that Tyvek is strong. You want your kiss?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. Night. Okay. You know what? That one will work. Well, that one's perfect. If I trim a little off of this edge, I'll be alright with that one. And same for this one. We're getting there. Get these three on, we're halfway there. I wonder. Making a difference. Oh, I'm holding the book upside down. That's why. Oh God. Okay. Major heart attack. I thought I'd put a page in upside down. Okay. I'm still breathing. Not by much. All right. Before that tight back is. Yes. It's good stuff. But, alright. So, it's upside down right now, okay? Don't panic. Like I just did. I want this one to go this way. This is going on. Okay. Perfect. That was a perfect fit. How in the heck did I do that one? Okay. Thought I had it on there. I guess not. Thank you. pieces. On the next one, before I add the tape, I'm going to do my cutting. And I apologize for all this taking so long. There. That one is done. Okay, we gotta go this way. Alright, this is a two pocket. So we're gonna do our cutting first. All my tools. So the center of this one is right there. Be the best way to do it is to don't forget, we got double tape on there. Basically, what I did is I went along the bottom here and just cut across, and then I bead it in. And hopefully, this seam should be able to bead in enough. Maybe. Dry fit. Oh, perfect. I don't believe it. Figured it out. Some glue there. Okay. So I know this fits. I'm so happy. Things I learned. One, don't double tape. Two, you're going to do pockets like that, do your cuts on your file folders, and then match it up with your other one. Three, post a sign with your husband. Alright, so I am just going to put my quarter inch as close to the top as I can. Changing how I'm playing this, because I'm going to do a quarter inch and then I'm going to do some glue on the bottom. Though I could do glue on all of it, which would make my life so much easier. But okay. A little bit, just down here. It's going the right way. Voila. Look at that. Can you believe it? With all the issue we're having with the other ones. Now that I've said that, I'll have issues. Like, no. It's bad enough I gotta stop my crafting in order to clean house and make sure my sisters have everything they need. When they come down. They're coming from Minnesota. It's about an 8-hour drive. Not too bad. When my husband retired, he gave me he put the decision where we're going to retire to in my hands, because as he said, he's dragged me around with the military without any say-so, so I get to decide where we're retired. So I chose it based on location. I do have family in the area. He does not. But we're only both our families are up in Minnesota, so we're only 8 hours away. We could have stayed in Washington State, but that's an airplane ride and a car rental. And, you know, it was, and I didn't want to be, we're both really, didn't want to be where they would be with us all the time and that, so. Okay, this is a single pocket. Yippee! So, we chose an option that was kind of in between. And I just realized I need to punch. That's the front. I'm thinking about it, you know, I gotta do it. My triples are getting punch. So, my problem. So I hope this has been a learning experience for you. It's been a learning experience for me. I like this style of mini album. There are things I would do differently next time, such as make sure if I'm doing these center things that everything is cut and ready to go. Perfect. The other thing is not double taped. I don't know why I double taped. I just did it. Don't double tape. On these pockets, you know, doing the top as score tape and then the bottom as glue is perfectly fine. Because if you run out of the size you like, you're not trying to get two different papers out. Make sure you don't attach your file folders together before you. Let's see. It needs to really stand out. Don't put your middle pockets in until after they're hinged on. And it might be easier to put the hinge on first and then put your pockets on. I think that's something I would do differently. Or actually, before I even put the hinge on, I would go through and my middle pockets that I had to do like cuts in that for, I would that's pretty well done. Okay. I would dry fit it, do the cuts, and then put them on. So I think I'm making another one, only on a smaller scale though. Not this big. Believe me, this is a big pocket or a big undertaking. Okay, this is my last one. I'm gonna okay, 3 1/4, 6 1/2. 9 3/4. Actually, put 3 3/8. I'll move everything over. There we go. 1/8 inch. Okay. So I know the scissors. See where my cut went. There we go. Almost done. Just gotta fight with these last three. We'll have it made. Alright. Now I'm gonna take my X-Acto knife, my ruler, and I'm gonna work better. right along the spine here. I'm going to go in. Side. Okay. Now, I just take my time. You see, that's perfect. Damn. Pardon me. Patty, no. Alright, so if you're going to do it in here, do what I did, which is just take your X-Acto knife along the hinge bottom and then do several cuts in and down. Angle cuts for your you might have to turn it the book around in order to do this right, but it does work. George, I've got it. I am so happy. Lessons learned. Okay. So lessons learned, people. That's all right. Okay, again, my quarter inch, and then we'll put the covers on. That worked better when I weighed it. So if you forget and you have to do them, don't tape your middle flap until you've gotten your dry cut fits done. Okay, a little more tape there. And again, I'll put the wet glue on the bottom here. Oh, this makes me happy. I'm going to flip this one and this one just for some interest. Do that. Okay, I've got it upside down. It's a little worried there. Got a little piece of tape there. I promised a friend I would take pictures of this. So I got to do some final pictures. Once I get it done. So. It's not 100% perfect. But as I always say, if you want it 100% perfect, buy machine made. Because that's the only way you're going to get 100% perfect. Alright, so, after much trial and tribulation and cussing, and wanting to throw it across the room numerous times, do a little clean up here. Making it harder on myself than I should have. Alright, so we're going to put the covers and the side on and the inside. So this is what we have. Yeah, I realize I got some matching papers there. But I'm okay with that. Just a lot of this one. I love these. And I'm going to do kind of larger ones in the front. That's why I wanted the extra. And you know, this black washi tape looks great there. That, because I want to do those on the front and the back, that's why the extra room is going to be helpful, because this is how big it is right now. So let's get our insides and our outsides cut. This is always the fun part. All right. So there's our insides. And I might do something fun with the back, with this. So our insides need to be eight and three quarters by 9 3/4. Okay. Eight and three. So there's our insides. Sides. Now for the front, I want this right here. So I know I want 9 3/4. Actually, I'm going to take it to 10. And you'll see why in a minute. Flip it. Hold on here. For the outside, I need 8 3/4 by 9 3/4. What am I thinking? Okay, 8 3/4. Yeah, that's why. We got another thunderstorm coming through by 9 3/4. They're all about the same size. Okay, so 8 3/4. I need this to go this way. Start with the inside pieces first. Or the front, whatever. Thank you. pretty good at driving that thing. Okay. I need to do it this way. My tried and true method. I should have made that bigger. That's all right. Maybe I can washi tape around the sides. Should be able to give this to my relatives on Wednesday. Just gonna run it over and drop it off. The front. This isn't going to be the best situation, but this is the top. I need to look at it and see which way I like it best. I think that way. That. Now for the spine, because I know it's 4 inches, and I need at least 4 inches. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna let the mess go. That would be pretty on the spine. Oh, perfect! Yes! Yes! No, I want that one. That is perfect. Okay, so I'm going to cut this down to 9 3/4 so it fits with everything else, and that will leave that nice border right there, and I'm going to do it smidge under 4. It's probably going to be about 7/8. So I know, I could have made these bigger. I didn't think about that, but I like my borders. Alright, so 9 3/4. I'm going to try it 3 and... Yes. All right, locked out. Yay. You know, I thought I'd thought about it. I'm going to still do it. I could run the washi tape from here, here, along the edge. I'll think about it. Okay, so let's get this on. And yes, I'm adding tons of glue to this. Simply because I want it to stick. Alright. Pull it up in order. There we go. Okay. That washi tape is such a subtle pattern. I like it. Alright, so for the inside,